right, here's a weekend challenge for you. Can you sort one column in a table using a filter without sorting the others? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. You know, one of the things I've been doing for 8 years or so is trying to answer questions, Excel questions, on Quora, the website Quora. I've done it enough that they send me probably two or three emails a day. And I always take a look at the questions and see if I, you know, happen to have an easy answer. Maybe I could point them to a video on YouTube or something like that. And yesterday, a question came across my desk that was so bizarre. Can you sort a single column in an Excel table using a filter without sorting all the other columns in the table? And what I found on Quora is the first thing you have to do is resist the urge to ask, why would you want to do this? Or, you know, this seems like such a horribly bad idea. And then second, you have to try and figure out what they mean. I haven't posted any questions on Quora, but I'm pretty sure that it's limited to like just a sentence or two, because you never get anyone who actually explains, you know, more about what they're trying to do. And this question is super interesting. You know, it's, can you sort just a single column in an Excel table using a filter? That's super interesting. Why do we have to use the filter without sorting all the other columns in the table? And as I try to parse that apart, the capitalization of the word table becomes really important to me. I mean, it's not that they typed in all lowercase. They did capitalize two words here. And so that lowercase table makes me think that maybe it's just a range and not a capital T table, which is what I use when I press Ctrl+T. So let's take a look at the easy one first. Let's say we want to sort by chariot and not everything else. And I understand this is a horribly bad idea. It's just a challenge. Can we do something crazy? And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to select just the chariot column first and then do data filter, which is interesting. That applies. Isn't this weird to see a filtered data set with just that one column? And then I open this drop down and say sort largest to smallest or smallest to largest. Now, this is such a horribly bad idea that Excel is going to nag us and say, you know, hey, it doesn't seem like you really want to do this. Can we expand the selection? And you have to say, no, I have a specific reason why I want to do this. You know, maybe the specific reason is they want to randomly assign tasks to, you know, some names here or something like that. And I would do that with index and ran between, but that's not the question. Can you sort a single column in an Excel table using a filter without sorting all the other columns in the table? We say sort, and bam, it works. Beautiful. But, you know, the nagging issue here, when they said table, do they mean that they've pressed Ctrl+T table? And when it's Ctrl+T, I can't find any way to do this. Like, I even tried to trick Excel by selecting something that starts outside of the table and ends outside of the table. You know, so coming up here and selecting this whole thing, but that is just, you know, no, Excel's not gonna be tricked. This is all grayed out. There's no way to do this. Oh, and I hate that sentence. As soon as I write or say, there's no way to do this, you know, five people will pop out of the woodwork with a way to do this. So here's the question, a weekend challenge for you. Can you find some way to sort a single column in an Excel table using a filter without sorting all the other columns on the table? And I think I'm even willing to take out the using a filter. Is there some way that we can just reassign those numbers other than coming out here, Ctrl+C, Ctrl+V to paste, then sort, and then Ctrl+C and Ctrl+V. You know, I even thought of maybe some clever formulas, but we don't have the things that Charles Williams has created, the H stack or the V stack, to be able to get the columns A and B in a formula, column C sorted using the sort command, and then D and E, and then putting all those back together. Yeah, I don't know. So it's just, this is one of those good weekend challenges. Hey, check out my new book, Mr. Excel 2021, Unmasking Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.